foster family takes in a boy up for adoption. Then they discover his true colors. Growing up's hard enough as it is. Throw in a lack of stable home and things become a thousand times more difficult. For 10-year-old Andrew, a life spent bouncing around the foster system was really no life at all, and as families passed on him time and time again, he couldn't help but spiral further into despair. But after Dominique and Kevin Gill decided to take a chance on the troubled boy, they revealed a different side of Andrew that would soon change their lives forever. In 2018, Dominique and Kevin decided they were interested in fostering Andrew. They lived in Nashville, Tennessee, and were empathetic to the poor kid's struggle. Andrew had been in the foster system since he was just 6 years old, and for 4 years he was shuffled between homes. Also, if you have not done so already, please subscribe to our channel and click that notification bell to get inspired by these real-life stories every day. Now, back to the story. With his biological parents' legal rights now terminated, the 10-year-old was facing another decade of fostering, though there was only another sad factor that made the situation more difficult. Andrew has 4 siblings and they were all adopted right away, Dominique revealed. This only made the Gills want to open their home to Andrew even more. Yet once Andrew arrived, he had an incredibly difficult time adjusting. During his first week with us, he sat in his room with a door closed and looked at old pictures, Dominique shared. He didn't want to talk. The 10-year-old had an extremely traumatic past and was carrying quite the emotional burden. Though Andrew was now in a caring space, it wasn't as if his past would magically disappear. He'd been hurt as his siblings were adopted. He'd been hurt by his biological parents. Having experienced so much abandonment, Andrew had a lengthy recovery ahead of him. Sadly, his situation wasn't unique. In Tennessee alone, there are more than 8,000 foster children longing for a permanent home.
They really want that stability in their lives.
At Molly Park of Youth Villages, a nonprofit that supports families in need through rehabilitation programs. The COVID-19 pandemic also complicated the foster system for kids like Andrew.
And a lot of families were unsure if they wanted to open their homes to a placement just because they didn't really know what the future held,
Molly explained. Even still, the Gills made the decision to foster Andrew and they were in for a rough time ahead. From the start, Andrew pushed the Gills away with tantrums. He'd start shouting, "Just let me move out," but I refused to give up on him, Dominique shared. He was like, "We're gonna get you together." Dominique and Kevin were determined to give Andrew a safe space to heal and be loved. After all, they'd already done it before. The couple already had a son named Jock, though he also had problems connecting with Andrew at first. They didn't think they had anything in common, that is until Jock asked Andrew to play a video game with him. Surprisingly, Andrew nodded. Gaming together led the boys to another important discovery. Both Jock and Andrew love Pop-Tarts. That was enough to bring the two boys together.
Tart, and they eat tart all day if you let them all day.
Tart.
They've been best friends ever since, Dominique revealed. Kevin agreed.
As the years went on, they got pretty close. It's always good to see that bond that they grew.
And with time, the boys grew even closer.
We had like a lot of stuff in common.
Games, Minecraft.
Minecraft, it seems, can bring all kinds of people together. There's just something about those cubes that people find irresistible. The preteens also have enormous appetites. They'll eat all day if you let them, Dominique joked. With more time, Andrew began to trust his foster parents. He shared his troubled past with them, and the Gills showed Andrew that he was a person with value who deserved love. Dominique and Kevin were ecstatic over Andrew's progress, and at that point they felt it was time for Andrew to find his perfect forever home. Andrew had been with the Gills for a year now, and while they knew they would be sad to see him go, it was all part of Dominique and Kevin's mission. The couple wanted to foster as many needed children as possible, just as Dominique's family had done while she was growing up. Yet all the while, there was one thing the Gills never considered during their fostering journey – adoption. But this sentiment wavered, however, when Andrew's second chance at a permanent home fell through. Our mindset was we'd help him until he found his forever home, Dominique shared, but after the second adoption didn't work out, I realized God put Andrew in our lives for a reason. God made sure the adoption didn't work out so he could come back to us. In June 2020, Andrew was surprised to meet Molly from Youth Villages, who invited him to a local park so they could talk. As they walked, Andrew recognized a group of people waiting there for him.
I just turned around the corner and saw everybody.
Yeah, it's a celebration, y'all! Hype it up!
Andrew saw the Gills standing with balloons and a big group of their friends.
They asked, "Will you?" And I said, "Yeah."
The Gills realized Andrew had been with his forever family all along and decided to make it official. Jock even wore a shirt that read, "Will you be my brother?" When Andrew agreed to be a Gill, the crowd erupted in celebration.
I'm just playing with you. I missed him.
Just really love him.
From the beginning, Andrew's always said, "Thank you for accepting me. Thank you for not giving up on me," Dominique revealed. people would read his file and get scared away. But I knew he was a good kid who had experienced a lot of trauma, Dominique continued. And so on July 16, 2020, Andrew got what every child deserves, a loving family. He's been outburst free for more than a year and continues to improve emotionally, though Andrew's presence has also posed a unique challenge for the Gills. The family does get stares in public, even though Andrew is well behaved. Because Andrew's white and we're black, people will stare at us, Dominique explained. They're confused. Fortunately, this doesn't bother Andrew. When he was first getting paired with foster families, he said he didn't care about their race. Love doesn't have a color. Andrew's our son just like Jock is our son, Dominique said. He's a part of us. Jock and Andrew's relationship has also continued to blossom. When we see them together, we're glad we decided to adopt Andrew, Kevin shared. It just seems like it was meant to be. In fact, the boys have become so inseparable they even chose to share a room, allowing them to game and talk as much as they want. They each have a TV, making it easy for both boys to play at the same time, and of course easy access to plenty of Pop-Tarts for fuel.
This is my brother, Jacquez.
This is my brother, Andrew.
Their sibling connection helped Andrew feel safe and accepted, and while hard days are impossible to avoid, Andrew found happiness with his adoptive family in a way he'd never known before. The Gills pay attention to Andrew's needs, knowing that adoption is a complicated and ongoing journey. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and consider sharing it with someone who may find it interesting. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.